Hey yo, what's up guys, it's me Mr. Yim here and welcome back to my channel. Today is a special episode for people who are owning a Atom Mini Pro and has some questions of how to set up and how it works. Please note that this is more of the advanced setting already. If you are still new, very new to Atom Mini Pro, I would suggest you to go to my first video, which is the basic of Atom Mini. I will link that in the description below. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you click on the subscribe button. I will deeply appreciate that. Okay, in that video, I actually explained of the most basic setup that I have, which means that using handphone camera plus a DSLR, which is also the most budget setup. And I also explained how all the button function of Atom Mini works. Alright, so I'm going to quickly go through my full production live streaming using a professional gear. As you can see from what I have in this video, I have two professional camera, two high-end specs, laptop, monitor, QSC, mixer, everything lumped into one live stream. And do note that this is a real example of a live streaming. A project that I can't actually show you the live stream itself as there are artists and influencers involved, so I'm trying not to show their face. But this is more just about the behind the scenes setup that we do for. Alright, so first up, we're going to use OBS as our live streaming. So this is the live stream computer, ROG Strix G laptop. You might ask, why a gaming laptop? Well, gaming laptop is one of the best laptop out there that has a better graphic card. Live stream works best with dedicated graphic card, not integrated. Integrated graphic card works too, but it won't last you for hours and hours of recording. So over here I have my second computer, which is a Surface Pro, just for presentation purposes or whatever presentation deck, Zoom call or whatever, or any other content that we wish to project out, this will be the comp. And here's the main hero product, which is the Blackmagic Atom Mini Pro. And I have used up all the HDMI input port plus one audio port. First cam will be the PS4, PlayStation 4. Cam 2 will be the main camera itself. Cam 3 will be a subsidiary cam, is for zoom in and zoom out. And cam 4 will be the presentation laptop. And here's the QSC audio mixer, which there is a lot of things going on. I'm not going to go in depth into this mixer. And I have connected with a DAC, which to extend my HDMI cable using SDI method. As you can see, it links out all the way out to my main cam. Sorry for the mess over here. I will need to extend the HDMI. I have no choice but to use a DAC to bring from the media server room to the main set room. And here's the two professional camera that I'm using. One is the Sony and one is the Panasonic, both output 4K, but it doesn't matter about the resolution as it's just going to capture the image only. Why do I use this professional camera for a home base? Well, it's just more for macro and a zoom in zoom out picture at a long distance. And I'm just going to connect to my tripod right now. Of course, all this mess is also because there's wire for the DJ set, followed by lighting, power cord, HDMI cable, etc. And once everything is connected, and here is how it looks like. I have my set with me, I have my wireless mic, I have my TV monitor. That monitor screen is just for the host to actually see what is projected out live. So once all the camera set up, this will be the close-up camera, this is the main static camera. So back to the studio, that's basically how it looks like with camera 2, camera 3, which is my main camera and also the close-up camera. And I believe I mentioned earlier, and cam 1 is linked up to with a PS4 going out at a HDMI splitter, and the splitter will go out to another TV. So I got to censor the video, it's not because there's some obscene material on the screen or whatever, it's just that because it involves artists and influencers, which I don't want to get myself into trouble later on when I just trying to share with you guys the whole entire setup of this Atom Mini Pro. And this multi-cam view is absolutely helpful in terms of your live productions.
And I guess this is one of the best product if you want to do live streaming. So if you guys are listening till this far, thank you so much. And over here, I'm going to give you some great tips. Maybe it might sound ridiculous, but I think this is something that you must keep in mind if you do really doing a live show. And these are actually the problem that I face in the live show, and I don't want you guys to make the same mistake like I do. I can do the same home-based video like how to use this, how to use Ether Mini to share with you guys, but I think the experience is different when you are doing live for somebody, because when you are doing for someone, there are stress involved, there are so many things involved that you might panic. You might not know anything will happen during the live stream, just like me. I also never foresee some of the problem before I do it. So if you are doing for someone, make sure you have at least 2 to 3 packs of people working with you. One will be the video guy, one will be the audio guy, and another one will be the helper running around and doing the camera operations, this and that. So it depends on what your client wants, I believe. So just to make sure everything goes well and nothing screw up, and make sure everyone knows what they are doing. That's very, very, very important. So if you want to do solo, I believe you can do it too. But once the problem comes, any problem comes to rectify, you'll be the one stressing. Next up, update the latest firmware. This happened to me when the Ether Mini Pro actually update by itself, while my window does not support the latest software of Ether Mini Pro. That caused me, I can't connect anything to my main computer, which is connected to do the live streaming, and it screwed up my whole entire production due to because of firmware. Next up is to reach early to your venue. You make sure that everything is working fine in terms of audio, in terms of visual, everything is connected. So for some people might think that reach 15 minutes earlier will do, because I have already set everything like the day before. But here's the thing, you never know that the thing update by itself, just like I mentioned earlier, and it will screw up your whole entire plan after that. And fixing the problem is not just 15 minutes, it's going to be like half an hour or more, because you need to trace what's the main issue. It could be the cable, it could be the Ether Mini itself, it could be anything. So 15 minutes, maybe if you are an expert, I'm not sure. But I only can say if you are sitting on that chair, you will feel the stress. So to sum it up, remember, this might sound ridiculous for the live production, but it's still something that I think worth thinking, because this is something that is kind of basic but overlooked problem. So lastly, there's some, I don't want to say it's a problem, but I think it's a black magic thing. I'm not pretty sure, but their port 1 only supports YUV. So whenever you connect to via SDI, this is what you get. Cam 1 only supports YUV, whereas the cam port 2, 3 and 4 supports both YUV and RGB. If you want to know what is YUV, maybe you can just Google it up and you will know what happened. At first, initially, I thought that my Blackmagic has some issue, but I didn't know that it only supports YUV, so now you know. But when you connect to HDMI, there's no issue at all, so you don't even need to worry about this. This problem only comes in when, if let's say you are connecting some analog video camera, then this will happen. Alright, so right now I'm just going to review some of the comment that was written on my previous video. So Josh Bubble here was saying, thank you for the explanation, I'm waiting for the stock here in the UK. I would love to see you set up 4 source and 2 audio, show us the multi-viewer. So I hope that this advanced video that I did actually explains the thing that you requested. But just one thing I didn't fulfill is that the 2 audio source, because I have a mixer with me, I only tap on 1 audio source, but the step is the same once your stop arrives and you try it and you understand. So next we have Manageri Kadalari. Sorry if I pronounce your name wrongly. Can I use on OBS for 4 HDMI devices in the same time? For example, if I want to see the same scene 3 camera, is possible, or it has the same problem with Ether Mini, only 1 output source into OBS? I think you asked a very, very good question here, as OBS can only capture 1 output at a time.
But you can cheat the system by using Blackmagic Atom Mini software to do this DVE effect. So you can do this picture in picture, so you can get two source in one scene. Next we have Bobby Stefano, and the question is, the USB out is recording, will your computer recognize your Atom Mini as the webcam via Ethernet? The answer is no, as Ethernet ports are only used to transfer data. Usually it's used for internet data. You can only use a USB-C to USB-C cable or a USB-C to USB 3.0 cable. Next we have Neo Stephens. What cable do you have connected to the iPhone? The cable is actually from Apple itself. It's a Lightning to HDMI. So you get your HDMI cable connect to your iPhone straight to Atom Mini Pro. After that, you just can capture everything from your phone. Lastly, we have Carl the Pagan. What's the USB video latency? You can compare with HDMI outputs into Cam Link or similar capture card. So far, what I use for my live streaming, video latency wise, definitely have, because due to the upload speed to the web and then output project to Facebook or YouTube, there will definitely be a video latency over there. But in terms of just studio recording via OBS, there is no latency issue at all. It's run butterly smooth. Alright guys, that's the end of my video. If you like this video, make sure you slap a like button. Be my friend by tapping the subscribe button and share this video around if you have any friend who are going to live streaming. I guess this video will definitely help them to also have a better understanding that live streaming for video, it's never cheap if you want to achieve a studio quality like setup. And I will see you in my next video. Okay, thanks, bye.